Hey everybody, welcome back to some more Pokemon Light Platinum, and today's video we're going to be taking on the imperils of Mount Oathstorm. Now there are three floors in this, so what I'm going to do is try and add to my Pokemon roster. So let's go to my backpack real quick, and you basically want to use a fire type. Now I have my Blaziken, but you can also have the Tyranitar that will know some fire type moves because you can teach a flamethrower. Dragon type Pokemon can know some fire type moves, so you are in the area of using them as well. But I'm going to stick to my Blaziken and train the others at a later time. You can just switch between the two. Like, I might focus on my Tyranitar as well and get this one with the Blaziken in the level 60 range, and then when we X on the other end, we should be good to go to switch around the Pokemon. Now, I am going to turn on some repels. Hopefully, I still have some with me, only because I don't want to walk onto most of the Pokemon that we see. There it is. Okay, Maxwell. I only have two left, so I didn't really stock up well on those items. But hopefully that should be enough to get me through the Mount Oathstorm part of it. Now, the first floor will have three trainers, all between two to three Pokemon apiece, but all will be level 38. As we're in Mount Oathstorm, they will be ice type Pokemon, so we will have the advantage. Like this Pokemon, for example, even though it is a Vaporeon and it is mostly water, it will know some ice type moves. So what I want to do is I'm going to use Slash, because I know water type moves aren't going to, fire type moves are not going to be super effective against it. But they all won't be like Vaporeon, they will be sometimes ice Pokemon. But unfortunately, I'm getting really unlucky with this first trainer just sending out this was just really annoying. Okay, hopefully there might be some ice type Pokemon. Okay, this one is not an ice type. Okay, forget everything I told you at the start. Apparently there aren't any trainers of ice type Pokemon. I think it might just be the wild type Pokemon. I actually thought there was going to be some ice types, but there wasn't. Yeah, okay, those water types do know ice type moves, but they're most dedicated to water types, so my fire type moves are not going to be super effective. Our first item is a Super Potion, which only needs three more to get, which is TM07 Hail, Ice Heal, and the Ultra Ball, which we will get that. There will be some NPCs as well throughout the journey, so we could always talk to them for some unique dialogue. There's some signposts around. This will be our next trainer, which will be Cool Trainer Gray. Hopefully he might have some Ice-type Pokemon. He will obviously have two Pokemon. Okay, send out Agavia, which again is not an ice type. I was really hoping for the ice type advantage. Maybe my strategy at the start wasn't, but with a name like Ice Storm, I was really hoping for the ice type genre. I think it's just the wild type Pokemon, which will be ice type. So now that we've figured that out, I might actually switch up my team and use other Pokemon. So I'm going to swap around and use my Blastoise. Switch that around to there. Only because at this point I want to make sure I get everything. This maze can be pretty tricky. We got the TM07 Hail. Okay, down here, down there. Okay, there we go. Almost forgot the pattern then. I'm going to go this way quickly. Okay, there's nothing there. Face the last trainer on this route. Or this floor, should we say. My team will show you the power of ice Pokemon. Huh. You know when I just said about, you know, I'm going to switch over and use my Blastoise? I instantly regret it now, because apparently we're going to have an Ice-type trainer. Probably while they get up is a dead giveaway, so maybe if they dress like they're in the winter outfit, they might have winter Pokemon. Jinx, again, doesn't have Ice-type, but is also a Psychic, so I should be alright. I'm actually going to use Ice Beam, because sometimes I could get it frozen. Okay, it didn't quite work. I'm going to use Surf. Okay, I knocked it out. And 52 on my Blastoise. Gonna send out Celio, not gonna change it, I'm gonna use Bite. Try and hopefully I can get the flinch, and there we go. So I did well on that one with my Blastoise. I am gonna keep my Blastoise because I could get to level 55 by the end of this video, which would be pretty epic, especially when we get to the Unarmed region. Like, we need Pokemon in level 70 range, but we got a long way before we get there. So that's all the NPCs on this floor, which is terrific. And oh wait, okay, I thought this one was an NPC for a second, but no, it's not. Okay, that's good. Sometimes they look so suspicious, but yeah, there should only be 3 NPCs on this floor. There's the Ultra Ball, and that should be every item on this one, 4 in total. Now we're on to the second floor. Now the second floor only has 2 items, a Lucky Egg and an Ultra Ball, and also only has 2 trainers, so that should be fairly easy for us to navigate around. And another one dressed in the ice getup. So maybe we further venture in, the further we may see a mixture of ice type trainers with a regular counterpart. I'm going to stick to what I know best, and hopefully I can just feed it with just my Blastoise. I could always switch to get the upper hand. Okay, there we go. I love using Bite because it gives me a chance of flinching the opposing Pokemon. You could use Crunch as well, which does more power, but it doesn't give the risk of flinching unlike Bite does. And I found the Lucky Egg. There are some areas where you will have to venture on, like, you know, you need Rock Climb in order to go up these. And I think I do have them. So let me just go to my thing. I might have Rock Climb somewhere in here. That's Rock Smash. Okay, I'm pretty sure if you have the Rock Climb TM, you can venture up there and get an item, which I believe that is the other item that we needed. So yeah, there's that. But I think it's like a... did we get the Lucky Egg? It's either a Lucky Egg or an Ultra Ball. I think we already got the Ultra Ball, so it must be a Lucky Egg. It's not really worth it. So it's, again, if you want to do something after you beat in the game and you want to go back and collect all these hidden items, you can do. It's just one of those mementos that they added in there. I'm going to use Surf on this one, which was somehow super effective. I forget about the types of them ones. And then we have Slowrock, which again, I should be able to use Surf to get the one instant kill. Marvellous. Okay, and there's the item. Okay, so I don't know where that leads to then. The Rock Climb, maybe it leads to another cavern. I'm not 100% sure, so again, that's something again you can just venture on when you're beating the game. This is the third and final floor, and there's again 2 items, Super Potion and Aether, and have 2 trainers on this floor, which again will have 2 Pokemon apiece at level 40. There's the first item, get that out of the way. I'm going to talk to this one and say I trained hard, and the hiker is going to be the next opposing trainer for us. So facing her, she will have a Glacy, which I'm going to use Bite. Hopefully I can get down. It's trying to make me get frozen, but luckily I didn't actually get frozen that time. Okay, this is going to be a steel type, so I'm going to try and use Surf, because I know Bite won't do anything. Even though I had a fire type, I could have easily defeated that one. I'm going to face the hiker real quick. And he will have 2 Pokemon level 40, and thank God he's a hiker, so we can mostly just expect rock and ground type and sometimes fighting from them, which I believe this one mostly be ground type, so I can just pretty much take down the first one and then take down the cloister with just a Bite. There we go. I'm gonna go up here, grab the last item. Now this fork in the road is blocked by Team Steam, so we have to venture on the other way in order to get to our next part in Mount Winter. So let's use my last repel, which did get me this far, which is pretty good, but again, it's not going to get me the entire of the way. But hey ho, we will have the backtrack to get past Steam. So Mount Winter is going to be that pitfall in the road, which is going to end today's video off, and I'm going to save Mount Winter for the next video, so that way at least that is a little more easier to understand if you're going this way for a guide. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. We did do most of Mount Ice Storm as much as possible, and now we're going to save Mount Winter for the next video. So if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, comment and subscribe. Until I'm posting a video, you do subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. But until then, take care.